If you haven't heard, Quantum of the Sea started cruising again in Singapore, becoming the first Royal Caribbean cruise ship to restart operations. With her return comes a lot of changes on board, and I'm counting down the top five most noticeable changes to the cruise up next. Hey everyone, it's Matt from RoyalCaribbeanBlog.com, and if you're like me, you've been super excited to see Royal Caribbean's cruises return in Singapore. Yeah, I know it isn't available to most people because, of course, these cruises are limited to residents of Singapore, but it's still great to see one Royal Caribbean cruise ship out there offering cruises. Hopefully, this will be a beacon of hope for the rest of the fleet and an opportunity for the cruise line to demonstrate that they can operate cruises in a safe manner. As expected, Royal Caribbean rolled out a ton of new changes on board that incorporate many new protocols and rules to ensure everyone stays safe and healthy on board. The cruise line calls its collection of new health protocols the Royal Promise, and it encompasses all the new changes on board to protect guests from the current health crisis. Royal Caribbean implemented a series of comprehensive, multi-layered health and safety measures that were derived from science, data-driven, and developed with expert guidance from the Healthy Sail Panel, Royal Caribbean Group's Head of Public Health and Chief Medical Officer, and the Singapore Ministry of Health. Quantum of the Seas has a reduced capacity on board and has implemented mandatory universal testing during embarkation and debarkation and enforced mask wearing, physical distancing, and enhanced cleaning practices across the ship, among other required practices. After seeing the first Quantum of the Seas cruise sail, I wanted to break down the top five most noticeable and important changes on board. Number one, I'm going to start off with something called the Tracelet. Something new for Quantum of the Seas and all of Royal Caribbean is a contact tracing bracelet, wearable device that you wear called the Tracelet. Now, contact tracing is really important in Singapore. Royal Caribbean and the Singaporean government require guests when they get on the ship, they must download a contact tracing app on their phone or collect a token. This is a device and a system that's actually derived from Singapore's government that they use called Trace Together. And it is a digital system which the Singaporean government has implemented to allow for better contact tracing in response, of course, to the global health pandemic going on currently. The system was initially made up of just an app by the same name and was later supplemented by physical token. The token and the mobile application work offline, but using Bluetooth technology and records the token ID of others in close contact of guests above a certain time. The token will not record your location data or whatnot, so don't worry about it if it knows you're going to the buffet for the third time. Guests will be provided another wearable piece of technology called the Tracelet. And this is something that Royal Caribbean trademarked a couple months ago and really didn't say anything about. And it was kind of like, ooh, what is that? Well, now we know, which will also assist in contact tracing on board. So guests will be required to have the Tracelet, Trace Together token app active always throughout the voyage. And crew members will also be required to participate in the contact tracing effort. The Tracelets really help monitor physical distancing and the cruise line's contact tracing procedures, which make sure that, of course, everyone's following the rules. And on top of that, if there was any issue with an infection on the ship, they can easily know who has potentially been exposed to it. So this makes everybody, again, a little bit safer. Next up is something near and dear to my heart, and that is, of course, eating on a cruise. And listen, we love to eat on board a ship, whether it's in the Windjammer Buffet, the main dining room, especially restaurants. Dining is a big part of the cruise experience, and not to worry, it's still a part of the cruise experience, even on Quantum of the Seas. Now, first and foremost, you'll notice not only in the dining rooms, but pretty much everywhere, social distancing is a big part of what you're going to be seeing there, right? A classic example is before you even get to the dining room to go for dinner, there are social distance markers on the ground to ensure that when people are lining up to get in, they're obviously not too close to each other. And dinner in the main dining room is similar to what I think most guests may be used to, although there are QR codes on the table of all the restaurants, so that you can quickly take out your phone, scan the QR code, and view the menu without having to touch any menus or anything like that. In addition, the Windjammer Buffet is still there, and it is serving guests in a full-service capacity. So instead of you reaching out to grab tongs and serve yourself, a crew member is able to deliver it for you and bring it right to on your plate. In addition to that, of course, if you want to get a drink, they'll give it to you. So basically, guests are not the ones touching these things. It's the crew members who have proper protection on to serve you on there. In addition, when you're in the dining rooms, whether it's the Windjammer or the main dining room, there'll be certain chairs and tables that are not available to guests in order to, again, foster social distancing on board. So there's a lot that goes into the dining experience. It's still there. It's just obviously going to be a little bit safer to ensure that there's not as much cross-contamination going on, which is obviously a very important thing. And let's face it, even without the whole current situation going on, it's not a bad idea. It does certainly foster a healthier experience on board the ship. The next biggest change on Quantum of the Seas is probably also the most noticeable one, and that is, of course, that masks are required for all guests and crew on board. For a healthier and safer adventure on board the ship, Royal Caribbean does require that all guests and all crew members must wear masks on board their ship, except in designated areas, like, of course, your stateroom. You don't have to do that. But even if you're going on to the Ripcord by iFly skydiving simulator, or you're going in North Star, you still need to be wearing a mask on board the ship. Now, wearing masks is something that I think pretty much everybody's been doing anyway, or should be doing anyway, for the last couple months, but being on a cruise is no different from that, and Royal Caribbean has instituted this policy from the get-go. When you walk into that cruise terminal to get on board the ship, you're wearing a mask. In addition, when you arrive at the cruise terminal, you'll also undergo a rapid antigen test, ART, at the terminal to ensure that obviously you're good to go, and that same test will be provided to you upon disembarkation. There are, of course, certain areas in addition to your stateroom where you don't have to wear a face mask. As an example, if you're on the pool deck and you're in the water, you don't have to wear one because a wet face mask really doesn't do anything. If you're waiting in line for something like the Flow Rider, you do need to wear your mask while you're waiting in line, but obviously not while you're actually doing the experience. So again, staff and guests must wear face masks until doing the actual activity. And this, of course, is to ensure that the most precautions are being taken while on board. Now, the next big thing is the big change to the muster drill. And I got to say, I am so excited for this change because the muster drill was always this just cumbersome event that everybody had to do. It's a safety drill on board the ship on the first day. And it required everybody to stop what they're doing, go to the muster drill, stand around. It was probably hot out. And listen to the same safety drill that you've heard 1,000 times. Even if you've never been on a cruise before, it's just, you know, it's cumbersome. It just stops everything. Nobody likes it. Anyway, let's now fast forward to Quantum of the Seas because we have now Muster 2.0, which is a new approach to the cruise ship safety drill. Instead of going to a muster station and standing in close proximity to others while listening to safety instructions, guests can conduct the safety drill from their stateroom television or through the Royal Caribbean app. So it's now digital and a lot easier. After you go through the e-muster on your phone or your stateroom television, you then complete the drill by visiting your assigned assembly station where a crew member will verify that all the steps have been completed and answer some questions. Each of the steps will need to be completed prior to the ship's departure as required by international maritime law. Once on the cruise ship, guests have a set time indicated by a timer in the app during which the muster drill must be completed by all the passengers. And in response, a message is transmitted to each mobile device that the muster drill has commenced. So you have your own time to do it. You don't have to do it exactly when everyone else is doing it, but it provides it in a much easier manner and less cumbersome. So that way you're not stopping and halting everything you're doing. The whole ship doesn't have to literally shut down for it to occur. You can do this on your own. And I think this is a fabulous change. I can't wait to do this on any Royal Caribbean cruise I go on in the future because, again, the muster drill was something that everybody had to do, but nobody liked doing it. So this will make it a whole lot better. And the last big change that makes my list is on the last day of the cruise, when the cruise is over and you're waiting to get off the ship, instead of congregating somewhere else on the ship, you actually wait in your stateroom. And I love this idea, actually. So on the last day, when your cruise ship pulls into port and you're waiting for the local authorities to clear the ship and, of course, for your luggage to be delivered, and then, of course, your debarkation number is called. Remember, when you're on a cruise, everyone is given a number to indicate when it is safe for them to get off the ship. Before everything going on currently with the pandemic, when a cruise would arrive at a port, you can't let everybody off the ship at once. Number one, it creates a giant mass line on the gangway to get off the ship. And number two, it takes time for Royal Caribbean to get all the luggage off the ship. So what Royal Caribbean does instead is they give everybody a number, and your number corresponds to your time in which you can get off the ship. It's kind of like a reverse boarding process on an airplane. Instead of boarding by, you know, zones or whatever, you have numbers and starts at the lowest numbers and works right up. So the higher your number is, the later your time. But traditionally, when this would occur, you would get out of your room because they would force you out of your room by a certain hour, and you would congregate in a public area, perhaps the Royal Promenade, perhaps the pool deck, in a theater. But you're basically just sitting around, right, waiting for your number to be called. Well, now on Quantum of the Seas, instead what happens is, because of social distancing, Royal Caribbean asks guests to wait in their staterooms for it to be called for disembarkation, which is actually, I think, a great idea because you're always waking up early anyway. You're tired. But in your room, you can lay down. Kids can watch TV. It's a lot more relaxed experience. And then Royal Caribbean calls the numbers. You can view this on your stateroom television as to which number is ready to go. I love this idea because, number one, I hated standing in line anywhere, really, to wait my turn to get off the ship. And number two, I think for families, this is a more relaxing environment to be able to do that. So once called for departure, lines and social distancing markers are set up for easy and safe departure off the ship. And as you depart, your temperature will be taken and you're required to have your CPAS card and tracelet with you, which you can then deposit as you leave the ship. So the disembarkation process is, again, a little smoother because of, in the name of social distancing, but I think from a guest perspective, this is a better experience. Now, obviously these top five changes are just some of them, the tip of the iceberg, as they say, because there's way more changes and protocols that have been implemented on Quantum of the Seas. But these are the five that I think are the most noticeable and also most important changes anyone would notice going on a Royal Caribbean ship going forward. And once more, these changes and protocols have not been confirmed for North America. There will be probably very similar changes coming to North American cruises, but nothing has been officially named. So keep that in mind before you start writing in the comments about how you don't want to do any of these things. Like I said, I think most are going to be destined for North America. But again, the contact tracing is an example. While the tracelet may come here, who knows? The contact tracing app is a Singapore government policy. In addition, the Singapore government prohibits drinking after 10:30 p.m., which is definitely not going to be a rule here in North America. So there's going to be some changes to be expected. We'll cover that in a future video for sure. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like button. Let me know in the comments also, what stands out to you the most? I'd love to hear about that. And be sure to subscribe to our channel. Yeah, so many people don't subscribe and you're just missing out on easy notifications when there's a new video posted. And I don't want you to miss out on all the fun we've got here. Thanks again. This has been Matt from RoyalCaribbeanBlog.com and we'll talk again real soon.